Hi, Ray Suarez for the Online News Hour in Mozambique's capital, Maputo. For years, this country's been considered one of sub-Saharan Africa's star performers, posting growth rates of 8.5%, 9% year after year after year. But still, even after all these years of growth, Mozambique is one of the dozen or so poorest countries on Earth, with an annual per capita income of about $500 a person. There's mineral resources here, there's timber resources here, there's terrific fishing, there's tremendous potential for the tourist industry, there's hydroelectric, but really Mozambique has not been able to capitalize on all this wealth in a way that makes its people any richer. In fact, after a decade of growth, the poverty rate is actually higher in this country. Even during these years of breakneck growth, the amount of food the country produces has actually declined. That leaves the country more dependent on imported food and thus more vulnerable to rapid changes in prices. Incomes have been stagnant. There's more stuff in the shops because countries like China have been able to churn out manufactured goods cheaper and cheaper and cheaper. So even the poorest people can afford new shoes and metal tools and textiles and so on. But they live so close to the edge. We talked to a shoe salesman who has to borrow money to eat that same evening unless he can sell two or three pairs of shoes out here on the street in a 10-hour day. So I want you to take a look not only at the Online News Hour, where we'll have reporters' notebooks, we'll have photographs, short video pieces, but also take a look at the PBS News Hour, where we'll have a full report on the broadcast on the Mozambican economy and some open questions about Africa's strategies for rapid growth to bring up the standard of living, not measured from 35,000 feet, not measured by an average, but to bring up the poorest of the poor and relieve the worst suffering at the bottom of the socioeconomic ladder. So from Maputo, Mozambique, the country's capital, take it easy and keep an eye out for our content here on the Online News Hour.